Though darkness fills the night, it cannot hide the light. Whom shall I fear? You crush the enemy underneath your feet. You are my sword and shield. Though troubles linger still, whom shall I fear? I know who goes before me. I know who stands behind. The God of angel armies is always by my side. The one who reigns forever, he is a friend of mine. Always by my side.
you this morning, God. We thank you for the freedom that we feel to worship you today. God, we give you our hearts. We relinquish this service to you, God, to have your way, whatever it may be. God, just have your way in our hearts. Let us hear your voice this morning. Let us hear your voice. Let us hear your heart this morning as we worship you. God, we praise you in this house. God, we worship you, Jesus.
Child of God.
No, and I'm no longer a slave to fear, but I am a child.
presence is heaven to me. Sing his presence. Treasure, the treasure of my heart and of my soul. Come on. Sing it out to him. Thank you. shout of praise. Come on, come on, come on. We're not holding back today. We're not holding back today. We're not holding back today, church.
Could not contain you, for you wear the victor. Lift your voices. Lift your voices. Come on, come on, lift your voices. Lift your voice, lift it. Lift, get on there, lift it. Lift your voice. Hallelujah. Lift your voice. Lift your voice. Lift your voice. Lift your voice. Hallelujah. 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 Every high thing, every high thing must come down. Every high thing must come down. I'm in an unusual mood right now. And I got news from heaven this morning that God is still in a good mood. I got news from glory today that God is still, Chris, God is still in a good mood. You overcome. You overcome. I got some ladies praying over a situation with another lady in the back. There's an impossible situation there. But God is breaking that impossibility right now. There's an impossible situation right there, but God's taking impossible out of the equation right now. There's Robbie and Duke in Durham. That's an impossible situation, but God's sending his word to Duke right now and taking the impossible out of that situation. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. There's power in the house of God. There's power in the house of God right now. Honey, I feel the Holy Ghost. Sherry, God's doing it, honey. God's doing it right now, honey. I'm telling you, Candace, God's doing it. God's doing it. God's doing it. Honey, I feel the Holy Ghost. Turn around and tell somebody, God's doing it. God's doing it for me. God's doing it, Ashley. Honey, he's not doing it because you're good. He's doing it because he's good. God is good. God is good. Y'all don't understand. I feel a river flowing through this congregation right now. A river of miracles, signs, and wonders. It's a new day. What is it? Is it a new day? Tell everybody as loud as you can. Oh, do it like you're hollering at Russell. It's, let's say it together. It's a new day. Come here, help me say it. Come here, yeah, come here. Let's say it together. It's a new day. Do you believe me? Come here, Rob. Rob Jane. Rob Jane, come here, help me. Guess what? It's a new day. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We break every chain off. The Spirit of God breaks every chain off right now. The Holy Ghost is moving through this congregation and breaking every chain off. Breaking, 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 breaking. I hear chains falling. I hear chains falling. I hear chains falling. I hear chains falling. I hear Jericho walls coming down. I hear doctors saying it's unreal what I'm seeing. I'm hearing financial companies saying, no, I can't believe it, but its bills are paid. I'm hearing it right now. It's a new day. It's a new day. How can I be sure? Honey, I don't know how I'm so sure, but I feel it with every ounce of my being. It's a new day. What used to hold me back ain't gonna hold me back no longer. What used to slow me down ain't gonna slow me down no longer. what has kept us from going to that next level, it's gone right now in the name of Jesus. I feel the anointing of the Holy Ghost in this house. My God, I praise you. I'm going to tell you something else. I feel a brand new parking lot coming on for this church. I appreciate the four people that agreed with me. I appreciate it, but I'm telling you, I feel something stronger than a parking lot. I feel something stronger than a parking lot. I feel the Holy Ghost coming on. What? A war dance. How many war dancers we got in here? I want every war dancer that's a war. I want you to come stand in the front and look back at the congregation. You want Sherry. Sherry, I saw you do it. Come on, honey. Hallelujah. My God, my God. Somebody said, what you doing? I don't know. I'll tell you when it's over. Every stronghold shall be broken. You wear the victor's crown. We overcome. I need one or two more dancers over here. Situation. I'm I'm going to give you just a few more minutes to defeat that devil in your life, to defeat the hell that's been coming against you. Jonathan, if there's any way, get all the welcome team up here as quick as you can. Get all the way. If there's anybody outside, get them up here, and I want all the welcome team just to walk right up here right now. And those of you that are going to be in the welcome team this coming Sunday, I want you to come right now. Bring it on. Bring it on. Come on, welcome team. Come on. Get up here. Church, my God, my God, my God. I feel the anointing, I feel the anointing, I feel the Holy Ghost. Feel God. Let me tell you what God's doing. You stay close. I might want to just lay hands on you, darling. I watched you work this morning, Eric. It was awesome watching you work. It was awesome watching our welcome members and our welcome teams work. But let me tell you what God's doing right now. In this house this morning, there is an uncommon move of God's Spirit, a move of God's Spirit that is very deep. Very deep. Even those of you that are sitting in your seat and you're not moving much, you are feeling the depth and the heaviness of God's anointing in this place. Everybody's not designed to be as crazy as Kay, but everybody is designed to touch God and be touched by God. But I want you to point your hands this way, in a minute, not right now, but point your hands, and I want you to bless this welcome team. They're serving the kingdom. But what God's wanting me to tell you is not only are we going to feel God's presence, but people that have never felt the presence of God are going to be brought and drawn into this place by this team. They have chosen to serve God. They have chosen to serve God. They're not choosing to get in line and be prayed for. They're choosing to form a line and pray for them. Because every time they welcome people into this house, God's going to start giving them miracles at the highway. The miracles are going to start at the highway because of the anointing that is on these people's lives. These are not people that are just just being trained to do some sort of psychological thing. We're doing a spiritual thing. We're pulling down the walls of hell in this city, and people are going to come running to God by the multitudes because we have anointed men and women on the front lines telling the devil, you may get to the front of our parking lot, but you're not coming in. And you're taking your hands off of every one of the people that turn into this parking lot. Now, there's some of you would really love to be a part of this welcome team. I'm going to give you 15 seconds to get in line right now. Starting right now. Honey, if you think this is just a group of people looking good out there in the yard, you're wrong. This is people that are going to save people from the jaws of hell. They're going to save people out of the hand of hell. They're going to save people from the enemy. Are you okay? You drunk? You hurting? Well, I guess you're going to be in the welcome team. Can't get her out. In the name of Jesus, point your hands this way, church. In the name of Jesus, I thank you for anointing every one of these people with an anointing of the Holy Ghost. I pray that their faces will show. I pray that their everything about them will show the grace and the mercy of God. I pray that you will anoint them, God, to do the ministry to the people. Do the ministry to the people. You want to pray over them a little bit? You go. Oh, you done sung your heart out, ain't you? Praise God. Lord, I praise you for what these people have started. And what has begun is going to be finished in the name of Jesus. Because we are going to win people until Jesus comes. Thank you for anointing them, God. Thank you for anointing them with fresh oil, a fresh power of God in the name of Jesus. I'm challenging you, if you've ever wanted to serve God, now is the time to serve God. Amen. Y'all go back, but I just wanted to tell you, we appreciate what you're doing from the very bottom of our hearts. You are a blessing. Amen. You're not just people. You're a blessing. You are a blessing. Amen. And I think Brother Saberio is, I'm going to give him a minute because I want him to, I've already given my tithes. And I'm going to put a little bit more in it. Hallelujah. My God, my God, my God, my God. I feel your presence. He's already got my money. Don't come to me, Ryan. Ryan, you can come to me anytime you want to. Precious Jesus. Precious Jesus. Precious Jesus. Father, I thank you for blessing your people. And I thank you, Lord, for everyone that gives. Pour it back on them, Lord. Pour it back on them. Good measure. Press down. Shaken together and running over. In Jesus' name, amen. Go ahead and receive the offering. Praise you, God. Your spirit is strong in this house, God. Your spirit is strong in this house, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Who said that? Who's yelling that back there? Who's doing the hallelujah? Spirit of Almighty God. Spirit of Almighty God. Hallelujah. I can honestly hear the Lord speaking to my heart. Don't look at what you haven't done. Don't look at what you haven't been. Just start looking at what you want to be and start walking in it. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay to start over. I don't care what age you are. I don't care what place you are. I don't care where you're at in any situation. It's okay to start over. It's okay. It's okay to be anointed afresh and anew. It's okay. Wish somebody would tell me which one of these messages to preach. I preach both of them. We'll be here till Jesus comes. He calls Satanabat Sotanabat. Yes, Marabat Sotorono because Shiko Mambrara Sitiata. Y'all forgive me. I'll do something in a minute. I'll do something in a minute. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I love you, Chardonnay. Hallelujah. It's almost like I'm standing in awe at God because I hear so many things just rumbling through my spirit. Midnight does not mean it's over. Because the minute, the next second after midnight insinuates and shows you new day. The very next thing, the closest thing in the world to midnight is a new day. Where you are, it can be dark as torment. And you say, I've reached a midnight. I've reached the darkest hour of my life. But next, you know, a second is even closer than your next breath. Your new day starts right now. Brother Warren, you're a good babysitter. That's all I can tell you. That baby is happy as a lark sitting up there. But that baby looks like me in the arms of God. I'm happy as a lark. I'm just as happy as I can be when I'm in the presence of Daddy God. I want to repeat one more time, and then I'm going to go back up there and I'm going to attempt to preach one of the messages I've got. I don't care. I don't care what your body's told you. I don't care what your billfold's told you. I don't even care what your best friend has told you. I don't care what the doctors have said. We have medical things in this church. We have medical things that's midnight material. We got some things in this church that are midnight material. But I hear the clock ticking. I hear the clock ticking. And it's about to hit second number one of your new day. Second number one of your new day. And you know there's one thing hell can't stop, and that's time. Hell can't stop time. You know at midnight tonight, 1 second after midnight, it's going to be Monday, and hell can't stop it. There could be an apocalypse. There could be 17 apocalypses between now and then. Every nation in the world can go to battle. But at 12:01, it's going to be a new day. It's going to be Monday. So I don't give a flip what hell is putting in front of you. I don't care. I don't care how many family members is raising the devil. I don't care how many supervisors are raising the devil. God says, I want you to understand your new day is coming. Just for the sake of talking, how many feel that you're at a midnight place in your life? Go ahead, just stand a minute. You're at a midnight place in your life. Are you serious? Midnights. Somebody standing up for Robbie. Is anybody standing up for you? Standing up for Robbie? Okay. Look at a mic. If one of these people need a new day. Out of the book of Isaiah, I want to quote one scripture. I don't know how you're going to make a light. Maybe you need to go home and get a lamp and just put it in front of you and look at it. But God says, arise and shine, for your light has come. Arise and shine. For your light is come. Arise and shine. Somebody find that scripture for me. Put it up on the board. I believe it's Isaiah 61. Is it? Isaiah 61:1. Put it up on the board, please. I feel the Holy Ghost. The devil's tried to make it seem so dark. I'm about to shout up in here because I'm going to tell you what. God never gives a promise he can't keep. God never gives a promise he can't keep. God, the Spirit. Nah, that ain't it. Isaiah, arise and shine, for thy light is come. Look that up, somebody. Look it up, please. Now that's a good one. And the Spirit of the Sovereign Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to preach the gospel. Isaiah 60. Arise, Jerusalem. Let your light shine for all to see. for the glory of the Lord rises to shine on you. First thing God said is, you rise, you let your light shine, even in the darkest moment of your life, you let him shine out of your mouth, your mind, and everything about you. Because God said, as you give and emanate the light that's in you, then he says, the glory of the Lord is going to come, and it won't be our light any longer. It'll be his light. I don't understand why I can't get in the mood of preaching like normal, but I'm telling you, God is saying, I'm taking you out of your ditch. Oh, can I go on and be a little crazier? God says, I'm releasing you from the witch. Hallelujah. I hear it. What does the witch do? She pronounces curses on your life. She's always telling you, you're not going to make it. There is no way out. She curses everything you do. But I break the curse in the name of Jesus. I break the curse. You're coming out of your ditch. You're being released from the witch. Some of you got witches in your family. And these witches are always calling you stupid and ignorant and a holier than thou. And always calling you everything but a child of God. They believe you're fanatic. They believe you're stupid. But I'm going to tell you, God's releasing you from the words of that witch, and God's getting his words. Honey, the light that you have held on to, you've held on to it. Y'all have kept saying, God, I'm coming to you. God, I'm coming. I need help. God, I need help. God, I need help. God, I need help. That's been all some of you could pray. That's been all some of you could pray. God, you don't have another prayer. You don't. You've come to the place that there is no help outside of Daddy God. If I may say another word, God says, I'm moving you out of desperation into inspiration. Don't let the poor boy be by himself. Don't. Honey, I refuse to stay in desperation. I'm moving under a new inspiration of the Holy Ghost. I'm not desperate. I'm not desperate any longer. I'm not holding on for dear life. The clock's ticking in my favor. Don't you worry, darling. Don't you worry, darling. God's got your day planned. God's got your future planned. My God. Y'all, I make no apology for how we have church. I make no apology for how we have church. I make no apology for how we have church. Honey, I refuse to apologize for letting the Holy Ghost pull you out of your ditch and killing your witch. Lord, it looks like I'm gonna preach that message one day. God will pull you out of the ditch and kill your witch. There'll be so many husbands in line, they would. Men don't understand that can be a witch too. Hallelujah. Mike.
Presence of God is thick in this place.
Presence of God is in this place. Y'all, I pray for so many people in my life. But I feel the Lord laying his hands on people in this room right now. I feel the Lord laying his hands on you again. I feel the Lord lifting you up to that next. If you thought she was crazy last April, I've been at home anticipating April. Oh, April's going to be such a big month in this church. April's going to be a crazy month. It's going to be horrendous what he's going to do against the enemy of our souls. God's building you up. God's setting the stage. Honey, quit thinking of yourself as defeated. You're not defeated. You are built on a solid rock. You're founded on a solid rock. The winds can blow. The rains can come. But whenever it's up with you, still go be on that solid rock. You've always been on the solid rock. God placed you there. I want to tell you something. You're beautiful in the eyes of God. You're beautiful in the eyes of God. You're beautiful in the eyes of God. The devil's lied to you over and over. But you're beautiful, honey. You're a beautiful woman. Y'all forgive me, y'all. But God wants to reaffirm to you today. I'm sorry. If y'all want to hear me preach, just go read my messages. They up there. If you just got to have it, you just go on up or you can start reading it now.
Thank you.
not God. Right now, if you need to lay it on the altar, I don't understand. Maybe it's just one person. Could be more. But if you're at that place you need to make and come just like he did, God, I can't take any more. I want you to come. I want you to kneel on that altar. Nobody's going to ask you what you're there for. God knows, no man has to know. I do not think this service went this way to leave you unsatisfied. I do not believe this service went this way to leave you in that pit and hung up with that witch. I'm telling you, come. I'm asking you to come right now. While the Holy Spirit's moving, Jana said a while ago, she said, it's thick in this place. Is it still thick? Is it still there? You feel it? It may not be midnight, but it may be quarter till. I don't care where you are. I'm not going to prolong it, but I am telling you, God wants to take somebody. Off of the edge and place you where you know you're in solid footing with him. You're on that edge. You're on that edge. My God, my God. This service has been way too passionate for it. It's been way too passionate. It has been way too in depth for there not to be something going on in lives. I'd rather have Jesus than anything I know. My God, my God, my God. I want one person apiece to come down and just one person apiece for those in the altars. Go down and pray for somebody right now. Just one person per person.
There wasn't a day that you weren't by my side.
Praise you, God.
There wasn't a day,
my God,
that you let me fall.
All
of our lives, your love will be true.
Sometime, God, will not minister to the 99, but he'll go after that one that's in terrible shape to minister to him. But don't you think that God's not looking after your interest as well? Today is the day to make a commitment to Christ. If you don't know Christ as your personal Savior, you need to walk down this aisle. If you're backslidden, running from God, you need to come down this aisle right now along with these people and say yes to God. You need to do that. I don't know what's up with us, but we're just different. But God wants you. God wants you. Father, this is your church. This service is your service, and we have done our very best to follow the moving of the Spirit and offer what you want to offer. Give what you want to give. Touch every person, Lord. Help them to understand that this invitation was straight from you. Help them to understand, God, that you care about them more than they ever dreamed. And you watch over them. And you orchestrate times where they can give their heart to you and they can give up trying and letting you do the work. Thank you for orchestrating this service, God, with needs in mind. Orchestrating this service with needs in mind. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise you, God. While these are praying, I just want to give you a short thought pattern so you can say I did preach a little bit. God wants you to raise your intensity level. How many saw Mike at the road this morning? How many saw Mike, the one with the yellow vest that was acting crazy? No, one more time. How many, is there any did not see him? Did everybody see him? What was he doing? Brandon, show him. No, Brandon, get up. Show him what he was doing. Candace, you get up. Do it. You know what? He wasn't out there going... His intensity level was screaming into the highway, come, come. His intensity level had reached. God wants your intensity. That's what the Holy Ghost was doing a while ago. That's what the Holy Ghost was doing in his church a while ago. And just like probably 500 cars or 600 cars, some of y'all just drove right on by and missed your invitation for divine inspiration. Mike, if you ever lose this craziness, I'm going to hurt you. I'm going to seriously bodily injure you. I love you, brother. The intensity level in this man is high. People look at me, though, and I've heard this so many times. Go ahead, Teresa. What are you doing? I hear people say, well, I'm just waiting. I want to hear the still small voice of God. And all around you, the devil is screaming in your ear. You're going to hell. You're not going to make it. You're ruined. You've tried and you failed. You hear him. You hear him. All you can hear is hell yelling into your ear. There's no way for you to hear the still small voice until you turn around and tell the devil to shut up. Shut up. Get out of my ear. And whenever you become louder than the hell around you, then hell will calm down and get out of your way, and then God can speak sweet peace to your soul. But I am to the place now, I'm refusing to let... So many times,
we do things in this church. And I hear so much negativity. I'm telling you, I'm kicking negativity in the behind, and I am going to get off my do nothing and do something. I would rather make a mistake doing something than ruining my chances of getting anywhere with God. Praise God. You will never hear the still small voice of God until you shut the devil up. I've watched way too many parents walk over to their irate child and say, "It'll be all right, baby. It's going to be all right." And them kick. And them kicking and letting their intensity level of tantrum. But there's sometime you have to take over. Mama says, "Shut up." Somebody said, "I don't want my child to be raised that way." Well, you. And you're asking, why would he say that? Because he's a detention officer. He works in the jail. Enough said. If you don't shut the devil up and raise your intensity level, he is going to carry you to your place of defeat, your place of poverty, your place of nothingness. And if you listen to him, you'll do what he says. If you keep listening to him, you'll do what he says. It's time for you to say, "Devil, shut up. Devil, shut up. Devil, shut up. I'm not dying. I'm not dying." I refuse to die. I'm going to live and declare the word of the Lord. Now, there's an unusual feeling in this church. Even right now, there's an unusual feeling. God's trying to grip you. Listen, you're living in desperate times. God has given us a Kairos moment. God has given us a window of opportunity to go to the next level. Don't you watch it go on by. Don't you watch it leave you sitting still. Honey, when the bus stops, I'm getting on it. If the bus don't stop, I'm going to run, catch it, and I'm going to ride the back bumper till I get there. Somehow or another, I'm going to have what God said for me to have. Mike's crazy. Mike got up a while ago. He said that word was for me. That word was from confirmation. And there was probably 15 or 20 more people right in this building that had the same word of confirmation. And you said and did the same thing that he did. But I'm going to tell you something. When you tell hell, "Shut up," then you can hear his voice. You can hear God's voice. Huh? You go, Mike. Now, let me look and read one more scripture, and then I'm going to close this thing out. I want you to drown out the voice of complaining with the voice of praise. Your voice of dissatisfaction, drown it out with the voice of deliverance. Family strife, you can cut out family strife by walking in full of revival. You can shut Delilah's mouth if you want to. Samson could have, but he wouldn't shut her up. He let the witch drag him down. Hello? Drown out the voice of disunity with the voice of unity. Intense praise brings intense presence. I want to say that again. Intense praise brings intense level. You know, don't come in here if you don't think we're going to be loud, because we're going to be loud.
Don't come in here thinking we're going to sit down and pet your pet sin and your pet devil. Honey, we come to cast him out. We come to cast your devil out. We are here to deliver you, not pamper you. You don't know what I've been through. Yeah, but look where I'm fixing to put you. I'm fixing to put you in the driver's seat. God wants you getting in the driver's seat and carrying your life where it needs to go. Go on and shout. Some of you quit speaking in tongues after the first time you spoke in tongues. Some of you hadn't spoken in tongues since you received the Holy Ghost 4 months ago. Honey, God wants you to be filled with the Holy Ghost every day of your life, speak in tongues every day of your life. God wants your intensity level. Honey, some of y'all pray and y'all never get above this tone of voice. Y'all just pray and y'all just let. Honey, I get crazy when I pray. I talk to God. You know, in a regular tone of voice, me and him conversate. But then there comes a time whenever I need to consecrate and dedicate, and I start kicking mess out of my life that has accumulated in my life. Somebody said, but you the pastor. You listen to 300 church members a while, you get some accumulation. I didn't mean to say that. You listen to some of your family members. You're going to get accumulation in your life. You're going to get some accumulation. If you be like these guys who work law enforcement, Brother Webb. I will tell you what. There's some accumulation come with that stuff. I've been there. That's why God made altars. That's why God made prayer times. That's why God made praise times. It's time for you to get violent with the devil and tell him, so listen, you have messed with me long enough. I'm going on with God. Get out of my face. How many have ever hollered at the devil? You've hollered at the devil? I'm feeling right priestly. Now, okay, I'm going to close with this. We're dismissed. As soon as I do this to you, you can be dismissed. But I feel like hollering at the devil. I feel like taking authority over him and letting him know, you can't have me. I tell you what, I want you back here Wednesday night, because Wednesday night we're going to have a little worship. We're going to have a little testimony time. I want you to be here. It's going to be good. Somebody say, okay. Now, if you don't let the devil keep you home. Okay. Sunday morning, I want you to wave at Mike on the way back in here, because it's going to be even more intense. But right now, if you feel like you've got a devil that you have not been able to break, I want you to come up here and just let me, don't even stop walking. I just want you to walk by. I'm going to command that devil to come out, come off, leave, do whatever. Wherever he's at, he's going to have to go. Somebody said, I don't believe Christians can have devils. I care less what you believe. I don't even care where he's at. You can have him in your shirt pocket, hip pocket, in you, out of you. It don't matter to me. He's gotta go. What? Oh, come over here. Oh, Lord, Mama won't talk.
I can't talk real good, okay?
You're doing all right.
Saturday before last, had such a migraine. It went on for like 5 days. Sister Betty Adams, she texted me to tell me she missed me. And then she prayed for me. And we were texting. She prayed for me. And on the text coming in on my phone, I could feel the healing coming into me. And the headache left just like that. And I want to thank God. We need each other in this place. You don't need to sit there and not love somebody else, not want to touch them, not want to go. Because I'm going to tell you what, she prayed for me and the heavens moved. And she texted me the other day and I was like, okay, I got bronchitis and laryngitis. She prayed. I wasn't coming today, but I haven't coughed maybe one time or two. So God has done it again, and I'll talk better next week.
So y'all pray for me. Right now, there's an anointing on me. And I'm mad at the devil. I want you to come right now and let me command the devil to take his hands off of you right now. If you've got something that's just tying you down, I need one of this woman said, in the name of Jesus, devil, take your hands off. 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 Ooh, shakasa. Devil, take your hands off. Give me a hug. I love you, Martha. Devil, take your hands off. My God. Devil, I said, take your hands off. Devil, take your hands off of her and the Hernandez family in the name of Jesus. Devil, take your hands off of her. This is God's property. Devil, take your hands off. Devil, take your hands off.